Welcome, everyone. Welcome, welcome. Hopefully, you guys are having a great day today. It is Sunday, Mother's Day. Hello, hello, Chirpy. Welcome. Yes, thank you, thank you. Yeah, happy Mother's Day, Chirpy, actually. Happy Mother's Day. Chirpy is my mom and my dad. We're here, day three of the consecutive stream weekend. Exciting, exciting. But alas, this is the last day of the charity event. But let's make it a good one. Let's make it a good one. We're gonna be playing Little Nightmares 2 again. We're gonna be continuing where we left off. It might be a tiny bit shorter stream. I know we started a little bit late. But due to Mother's Day and such. Back to Liddy Little. Liddy bo little body horrors, yes. That is very true. That's what the game should be called. Bum, 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 bum. I'm excited to get into it and not see that long neck lady. I think we're past her, though. I'm just looking over, you know, where the game is and everything. Tiny baby horrors. But yeah, today marks the third day of our charity stream for the Game On 10 Lupus event, and I'm very excited. We reached our goal. We're at you guys can see it up there. $110. $110. So someone actually donated $5 when I was offline. Which is incredible. Very good. I am also baby. I'm also baby. What I want to do is I'm going to, I think, pop up some videos about lupus and stuff today, just for a little bit before we start and get into it. Let me set that up. We're gonna soon and I'm gonna just move over. But how are you guys doing? Hopefully well. I'm looking for the video I had bookmarked. Well, good luck with your art project, and that'd be nice if you could go out. It's always nice to just put makeup on, though. Sorry if you guys heard the quick moment of, oh, the desktop audio was muted. Okay, thankfully. We're just gonna make it this small, make this smaller. I was supposed to have it set up before, and then I didn't have it set up. Okay. Have a little video. Uplifting music. Yeah, the subtitles. Yes. We're here. Let's go. Yeah, we're just gonna be watching some like general information videos, just a couple provided by the Lupus Foundation of America. Very exciting. I'm gonna move myself over. Hopefully I don't. Oh, your chat goes over me, so I won't block your chat. Welcome, Kai, though, by the way.
They told me that there was like a lot of protein in my urine. We went to the doctor's office and they said, "Oh, you're gonna have to get a biopsy." When I found out that I was gonna get a biopsy and that I had to go through chemotherapy, I was really scared. I didn't know what was gonna happen. I didn't understand any of it.
Children are not small adults, but specifically for lupus, the kids have a slightly different disease. It is more severe. For example, the kidney tends to be severely affected and affected more frequently in kids than adults. By the time the traditional tests of lupus nephritis are positive and you see evidence of kidney involvement, the kidneys are already damaged. We were really motivated to develop a non-invasive test for lupus nephritis. Our idea is to let kids and families of children test themselves at home as a way of monitoring their own kidney function. If you can provide early treatment before the kidney is very inflamed, you can probably get away with less burdensome treatment and you would spare the kidney over time.
So this video is called their Lupus Foundation of America Research
It took me
Initiatives.
about 2 to 3
So this is
years
what
to
they're
be
trying
properly
to
diagnosed. None of
research
the
and
doctors were
what
really
money
able
would
to
go
tell
to
me
researching.
what was wrong. One of the things I would love is if we could just have one test and it was quick and easy, and then we can just know exactly what it is up front.
Early diagnosis of lupus is crucial.
So, okay, I'm gonna pause it real quick. So this is actually a really big point. It takes a long time to diagnose lupus. It takes a lot of tests, and there's a lot of hella tyrant. There's a lot of diseases that actually mimic lupus. So, it can be really, really, really hard to get diagnosed. In my mom's case, she wasn't diagnosed for at least 2 years. She could have been diagnosed sooner, especially because it's uncommon in children. How are you doing? We're watching educational videos before we get into the stream. Just a couple. It's really nice to hear the personal stories, though. It kind of it's easier than reading an information document, you know?
Critical for several reasons. First of all, we avoid incorrect diagnosis, which avoids incorrect therapy, and it also may prevent future complications, some of which may be catastrophic, such as myocardial infarction and stroke. We made the discovery, actually serendipitously, that the blood cells of patients with lupus in the circulation are decorated with molecules that should not be there. We learned that these biomarkers on these circulating cells can help us enormously to diagnose lupus, to monitor activity of the disease, and to predict future events. We made our first discovery of our biomarkers literally 20 years ago, and it has just recently gone from the bench to the bedside and become available for physicians treating patients with lupus.
I'm also glad I can educate people on this because it is very not commonly known.
It's not just the disease, it's the medications too that you have to deal with, how they affect you. I have to take Plaquenil. I have been since shortly after I was diagnosed, and I was terrified at the beginning to start it because I didn't want to go blind. That's what I was afraid of. I have to go to the ophthalmologist twice a year and do about an hour and a half worth of testing on top of all of my other appointments just to make sure that the Plaquenil isn't damaging my eyes.
Plaquenil can lead to toxicity to the retina and potentially cause vision damage. Our study is to use nanoparticles to deliver antimalarials such as Plaquenil to specific cells in the immune system that causes lupus to become worse. We think the benefit of this delivery method would be to the patient is that they're able to use less Plaquenil over time than with current treatment regimens, thus decreasing toxicity to the eye and other sites of the body.
Yeah, it's not, I don't think a lot of people
if you think about the last
talk about
10
it
years,
when they have it.
It has seen the development of very targeted therapeutics, and we need to be able to exploit that knowledge and use it to stratify patients who will benefit from specific drugs and develop new drugs using that same template, but drugs that are even better for lupus.
Knowing that there's research, knowing that there are advances being made and people actually investigating what's going on with lupus gives me hope.
Seeing other people supporting the cause makes me really happy because it makes me feel that I'm not alone.
Definitely important to support by donating and advocating so we can figure out exactly what lupus is and how we can attack it and really find a cure.
Without a doubt, our greatest needs in lupus research are more dollars and more scientists. It's not a question of if we can cure lupus. It's not a question of if we can prevent lupus. It's a question of when we will cure and prevent lupus.
Martin Luther King Jr. has this awesome quote, and he says that if I cannot do great things, I can do small things in a great way.
So that is the first video. So that's a nice way to go over the what they're working on at their foundation, because it does include personal stories. Lupus does mostly affect women, but it can actually affect men as well, and there are no age limits. Anyone can get it. So it does affect a lot of people. Though you might not hear about it very often, the people that it does affect, they tend to be very vocal. So it's really nice to see everyone streaming this weekend. There's a lot of people who are streaming that actually are affected by lupus themselves. They're lupus warriors. So I actually have I have tons of respect for everyone donating, but especially the people that are lupus warriors, they're really putting their personal experiences out there as well this weekend. It is very inspirational. Now I'm going to put on the second video. Oh, let me go over what lupus is actually, since that just says what lupus research does. So, lupus is a autoimmune disorder that affects your body, and it can affect anything as simple as your skin to your internal organs. It basically makes it so your body, your healthy cells get attacked by your immune system. There's currently no cure, but there's a lot of medication to help manage it, but the Lupus Foundation of America, the charity we're just talking about that made this video, and the one that we're supporting this weekend, they are putting research towards a cure. And I think they're the only national organization, or the only organization nationally trying to find a cure. Yeah, exactly. It's easy to feel alone, so I'm glad that all these are out there for people who are, affected or have family members who are affected. because it makes you feel less like you can understand it more. Because from a personal experience, when I was growing up, I didn't really know what it was or anything. And because, you know, you don't really see the effects firsthand when you're younger, right? But I think it's very important, especially having someone affected by it in my family. I think that it's very important to educate yourself as much as possible so you can know where the other person is coming from that has this disease and what they have to deal with and the treatment that they are going through or may be going through. Yes, I am the shoe goblin. Or I will be very shortly. I will be very shortly. Welcome, welcome. We're just watching some educational videos. But we'll be getting into Little Nightmares shortly. Let me get our second video up. I'm doing great. How about yourself? All right, I have our next video up. This video is called What is Lupus? So it's going to be going over personal experiences as well as explaining the disease a little bit better than I might have explained it. Yeah, so it's an invisible illness. It can definitely have physical ways it represents itself, but it's mostly invisible. So a lot of people that have it, you actually can't tell that they have it, since it's an autoimmune disease. It is hard to actually see that someone does have it. Wait, I moved myself over. I meant to move this over. Well, I guess it's fine where it is.
Lupus is hard to describe.
How would I describe lupus?
A internal war with your own body.
Do you feel like you have been hit by a Mack truck?
Lupus feels like someone smacked you in the face.
You know, they're like, you don't look like you have lupus.
People don't realize that it's painful, physically and mentally.
Lupus is like the bully at school that you always try to avoid, but it always finds you, beats you up, and takes something away. Your friends, your energy, or even your ability to do simple things.
It's unpredictable and hard for others to see.
It's like waking up every morning to your own personal game of the lupus lottery.
You now have chronic pain, extreme fatigue, and kidney failure.
It's hard to understand.
Lupus is hard to wrap your head around.
The simplest way I can describe it is
the never-ending flu.
Lupus is a chronic autoimmune condition where your immune system starts to attack self. In lupus, that attack can be on any organ system in the body, which makes it difficult to diagnose. It's a chronic disease. There's no cure. It tends to target women between the ages of 15 and 45, and women of color are 4 times more likely to develop lupus.
It's hard to live with.
Imagine driving a car, but your taillights are out, your tires are going flat, your parking brake is engaged, you're leaking fuel, but yet you still have to figure out how to merge onto this interstate at a high speed. You have to still do it. That's what living with lupus is like.
It's hard to treat.
Lupus feels like you are in a boxing match and you are blindfolded with your hands tied behind your back and you're supposed to fight. How can you fight?
It's difficult to diagnose because every patient can look a little differently. There is no cure for lupus, but there are medications out there that can help treat the disease.
Lupus is hard.
But you're not alone.
I get answers I need on lupus on lupus.org.
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 All right. That was our second video. So, you saw the gap between. But yeah, so let me go ahead and. So lupus.org is basically the charity site for Lupus Foundation of America, but it's also one of the best resources to learn and educate yourself as well. Let me go ahead and put the link for you guys. So that, so yeah, it's pretty good to see it that way too. I like how they use analogies because, you know, it can be hard to understand, especially when you're trying to educate others about it. It can be really hard to understand. So, but we reached our goal yesterday, which is really exciting, really exciting. We're at $110 out of 100. So we were a little bit above our goal. Incredible. And it's all because of everyone here. So I'm really, really thankful. But, yeah. But every, so basically that's where the donations are going. They're going to research and advocacy, as well as just general outreach support for people affected by the disease. It can be hard when you're diagnosed with something that not a lot of people outwardly talk about or know about. And to have these resources are really important for patients. So, it's really good a foundation like this exists. Yes, 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 yes. But it's not, as the first video said, it's not if there will be a cure or if there it will become preventable. It's really when, because it will. A lot of people work hard every day, a lot of scientists, a lot of researchers, a lot of people showing their support and using their voices to raise awareness. So, amazing people. So, yes. Thank you guys for coming to my educational segment. I wanted to start with some videos just to, like, I explained it the other days as well, but this is a little bit different perspective. Yeah, exactly, exactly. Yeah, incredibly motivated people. Okay, now on to what we're playing today. We're going to be playing more Little Nightmares when Shoe Goblin time. Shoe Goblin. Because I will be picking up shoes. Without a doubt. Time to rob. They don't need them. Okay, let's go over to... Let's go over to our other screen. Wait, guys, my controller is not plugged in. After yesterday, I know you guys. I know it's, I know you guys are so excited to see my pro gaming moves. Because after getting hit with a bucket 8 times, very fun. I can't believe that was clipped. It's so funny. It's so funny. Oh, thank you. I said happy Mother's Day to Chirpy because she's my mom. But yes, happy Mother's Day, everyone. I hope you guys are doing something, even if it's just by yourself. You know, it's still a holiday. I know not everyone has the greatest relationship with their parents, but I hope that you can enjoy doing something else. Yeah, I'll just put it up. I'll just put up the clip while we're here. Mama Musei. I haven't been called mom in a while. Okay, let's see if I can throw this clip up. Why is it upside down? Can we answer? Why? Why? I don't have it upside down. I don't understand why. Hold on. I don't know. I don't. Hold on. One moment. It gives you an idea. Wait. How are you doing, by the way, Kai? I liked your Miku drawing. Okay. Let me just make this smaller. Okay, all right. We'll watch it over me. Actually, I'll move over. It's a good clip, though. Good in what way? Well, I don't know. It's pretty funny, though. Let me flip your laptop upside down. All right, looks good. Wait, let me make it bigger. Let me make it bigger so you guys could see. Oh. Yeah, Sunny Lion clip this. It was a pretty tragic 10 minutes.
I told you guys, it's hard. I keep hitting the thing. I'll just sit here. I'm really sad right now.
All that struggle just to get hit by a bucket. Tragic. Thank you, Chirpy. Thank you. Yeah, pretty tragic. I think I spent like 10 minutes on that part or something like that. I was supposed to be a little bit. There was like an invisible wall. So. Okay, I have my controller in now, so we will be. Yeah, so there is there's a lot more action than the last game, aside from horror because it's really scary. Leo, I don't want to be famous, okay? I'm already everyone's favorite fish idol, okay? Hello, welcome. I've been getting a lot of bots recently. They've been like, hey, you want more followers? And I'm like, stop, get out of here. Leo bot though. What if you had like alt accounts just like Leo bot? This game does autosave. Hopefully autosaved after the long neck lady because I really don't want to deal with her again. I don't. I have a strong dislike. Okay, it didn't. It saved here. Cool. I'm so relieved. That was the worst. It's literally, it made my stomach churn. Like, that's how gross it is to me. I've never really been grossed out like that in a game. I don't think. In a while. Thank you for the $1 donation. I have to read what it says. I can't read. My eyes don't work well. Okay, that's one thing I really like about... That's one thing I like about, I'm glad you're doing good. You're about to draw Mama Musei. Whoa, I have that to look forward to. But thank you so much for the $1 donation. Yeah, any amount helps. So I really appreciate it. I'm excited for Mama Musei, but at what cost? Yeah, this whole area is pretty bleak. Those are the shoes I want to steal so badly. We'll wait. We'll wait. We'll run, though. I mean, that used to be, like, my thing. People call me mom all the time. Maybe I don't go in here. Oh, maybe I do. That looks unsafe. Oh, I could have gone around. Oh, we pull it. Okay, okay. Oh, I see. I think we can make this jump. Okay. Can my little friend make the jump? Oh, he can. Oh. Maybe I gotta... We gotta move it further. Maybe? We don't know anything about... No, we don't know anything about them at all. Just that they're here. I must have gone to rescue them, because I don't really see why else I'd go in that scary, super scary house. But we do have this weird mystery involving TVs. Oh. Okay. Wait, don't jump down. Guys, this is the hardest puzzle in the game. Excuse me. I just barely did it. You can make it, I believe in you. That's a loud rain. Come on. But if anything bad happens, I killed like multiple people for this guy. Okay, wait. You know what's really crazy? They killed someone, my little buddy. And they just choked the guy out. Just snuck off on him and strangled him until his head popped off. I was like, what? I was like, that's crazy. So yeah, we have these collectibles, right? And there's some shoes in that trash can. Yeah, we have collectibles. They all seem to be TV focused. I even hacked a TV and, my little buddy guy pulled me out. I want to take this. You want this? I guess I can't take it. What is that? What is that? Wait, is this the character from the first game?
It is the character from the first game. I got an achievement called True Colors. Let's spin him around. Yeah, I guess this is 9. Well, I don't know, I'm not for sure, but I got an achievement with 9 on it. And it said True Colors, so... But why was it here? Where did you come from? Okay, well, hold my hand, I'll keep you safe. It's so cute when they hold hands, I love it. So wholesome. Alright, big clothes for big people. The lore of this game keeps pulling me in. Can I... I can't see anything. Yeah, I feel like the first game was pretty open-ended. I know some people say that the lore is a certain way, but I think it is pretty open-ended. Can I have these? There were no shoes. There were none. You have a raincoat? I don't even have a raincoat. I guess I have like a hat. Oh, you could get hats in this game. I guess I have a little hat. We could kind of be matching. I've been using the default hat. I think I've gotten every hat so far. This hat probably won't help me with getting wet because it's just a hat. Can I pick up this hat? No. Is her name 6? It's not 9? Rip, I'm sorry I called you the wrong number. Can't you just grab it from this side and push it? I don't know why I have to push it. Come on. Doesn't she have powers? And doesn't 6 have powers or something? I think. It's been a while since I played the game. It would be cool if the hats gave perks, but... I feel like it's not going to, unfortunately. Oh, I have to crouch. You can kind of see the main character's face. You're in my way. Oh, fine. I wanted to see my face. It's just the reverse number. Why are we at another school-looking building? Why does this look like a hospital or a place with beds, which I don't like? I'm still terrified of the school. I don't want to go back. I'm scared. I got achievement unlocked. Schooled. So are we back or is this a different school? I swear to God we went forward. I swear. I don't want to be at school anymore. I do not like hospitals. I think schools and asylums, maybe I could take. Hospitals, no. Even like actual hospitals, they kind of scare me. There's no shoes so far. This is a shoeless playthrough. Maybe there's a shoe right here. Ew, why is it all bloody? I don't want to stand on that. Gross. Oh, look. some guy in a wheelchair. Okay. So this isn't a school. This is definitely a hospital. So this we actually got past the school. Okay, no more long neck lady, but I don't know what's next. Yeah, all the bandages kind of made me think that, and then I was like, help me. Let's make a bunch of noise. Wait, you have to help me. This is... So who's making these? That's what I'm wondering. Who is navigating these areas? I had this question yesterday when I saw, Oh, now you know everything. Now you know everything. I like how knowledgeable... She got as soon as she put on the jacket. Maybe she just didn't remember who she was, though. Don't you see this at, yeah, it's normal, Tyrant. Don't you see this at every hospital? Every hospital has this. This is when you go, when you get admitted to the hospital, this is what it is. Wait, I let go. I gotta change my hat. I keep getting confused. We have a couple hats. We have this hat and this one. This hat is kind of morbid. Sorry about my cursor. This hat is kind of morbid because we took it off some dead guy. Okay. Very normal. I don't think there's going to be any shoes here, guys. I think this is a shoe-free zone. I like the default ones. I'm going to switch to it as well because I really like the bag head. Like, in contrast, it's so cute. It reminds me of, what's that little cardboard? It's like a Japanese character. It's, a little cardboard guy. It reminds me of that. Wow, that's really loud. It reminds me of that. Game over? Wow, that's a game over. Domo is similar, but it has like kind of a triangle mouth. We did grave rob hats, which is unfortunate. Maybe we could do this. Here, I have an idea. Let's use... No. I have an idea. This is probably like the same weight as me, right? Oh, Donbo. That's what I'm... That didn't do anything. Maybe I'll get a bottle. I think I'm thinking about Donbo, yeah. You see these? There was one shoe, but I can't pick it up. Okay, so. Help me. Leave me. I literally helped them this whole time and they just want to leave. Wow, the sudden independence they've gained. They're really cute. They're really, really cute. I really love the little Donbo guys. I like Domo too. B to use flashlight. Oh, this is a new feature. I like how they cram so many features in this game. It feels like a, I mean, I know it's a sequel, right? But it feels like a completely different game. Like, mechanics-wise. Hey, I hate this. I don't like it at all. My flashlight control is about to be awful. I don't like the flashlight. Why can't there just be like a light? Oh, a collectible. We not supposed to go there? Where are we supposed to go? Yeah, it's really an amazing game series. I love the first game. This one looked... I knew when it was coming out, I wanted it really bad, but... It's, like, amazing. It really has been super enjoyable, and I've only played, like, what, 3 hours? And they're super playable games, like, not very bad lengthwise. Okay, well, it's not here. Sorry if I keep shining you guys in the face with the light. I keep putting it at the camera. We gotta go down this scary hallway. I feel like I'm playing Outlast right now. Why? I need to hit this button. Oh, did I get a can first? These are some short vending machines. What kind of pop is this? It's like a Coke or something. I'm a little bit nervous. Just a little. Just a teeny bit. Just a tiny, teeny. Oh, it's one of these. So she is affected by it, too. You gotta turn it off. These people don't have heads. So this is what I was talking about, the TV part. These people are just parts of people. They're not people at all. That seems to be the theme. I gotta focus the signal. Okay. Yeah, I have to focus the signal. I have to do it more than twice. I wonder if they get harder. It's like, yeah, it reminds me of Poltergeist or some weird horror situation. It wants me to open the store. So when you first start the game, it shows this too, you going towards some door. Trying to open it. And it has those black shards, like the black dust. But she's pulled me out every time. Yeah, I really don't like this. Don't like anything about this. I guess they're fine, though. It looks like we need, like, fuses or something to put in there, and then the lever. I'm gonna look in here first. It's actually a super interesting concept, yeah. Hello? Look at, there's a teddy bear with a key in him. And then some actual people, brain scans. There's little people. Look at how big this is compared to him. I love this. It's so good. You picked up something you like! A simple monkey. That's great. I literally feel like I'm gonna cry every time she picks something up because she doesn't pick things up very often. I know. I'm gonna take him. I don't know if we need anything else in here. Oh, see, you see drawings of the TV and the eyes and stuff.
Hmm.
Oh, there's a key. Is there a key in that? Does that mean you have to... wait, stay there. Stay there. I want to see again. No, this is just a bear. Do we have to find the right one? Okay, I'm gonna set you down here. Just... there you go. Maybe... this one? This one looks kinda... questionable. I mean, it's still, I guess, cute. It looks like it's like a dog, maybe? Maybe we put this back here before. Okay, we gotta move the thingy. This teddy bear, we gotta move it all the way over here. I love him though. Even though he looks kinda cursed. It's like, in a cute way. But I kinda find some scary things cute. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to put you in the corner. Putting you in the corner, think about what you've done. Which is nothing. You didn't do anything. What is doing? What is she doing? That's what I'm confused about. So that... did it just blink? Please don't tell me these things are gonna come to life, because that would really be the worst, I think. Let's try this one. It's another bunny. I thought for sure it was a teddy bear, because it kind of looked like a teddy bear. Those look really cursed up there. Like, really cursed. Okay, alright. We're just gonna leave the room. I went behind. So this is the one with the key. Ew, I hate x-rays sometimes. They're so scary looking. They look scary. Like, and I get why they have them in horror games. Do you think it's up here? Or should I go in this? Maybe I should go in this elevator. I'm gonna go in the elevator. Oh, it goes down. I don't like that. I don't really like this. I enjoy this game. It's actually really scary. So one thing when you play the first game, Tyrant, I know you played a little bit, but I feel like it's not this bad. What does this do? Put your item in here. Yeah, put your thing in there too. Good throw. I don't know why they upped the scare factor. These would be really hot. Why would I go in here? This seems like a bad idea. Where's the other thing? I kind of thought there was two things, not just one. Like, why did she throw hers in there? Let's look around. Can I go in here? Oh, I can't. Okay. I don't like when stuff like that is open in games, because I'm like, was something gonna pop out? Yeah, they're both definitely body horror.
Okay.
Okay, we already got the key, so we don't need to go in here. But where do we put the key? That's an important question. Up here? I wonder if I can run out of batteries. So, I'm gonna see if this does anything, because I don't know. Okay, I guess not. I don't like these things one bit. And it bothers, like, I almost feel like sometimes it would be better if it was real people instead of, like, inanimate, like, people meshes. Maybe it is a real person. I don't know. That's what it gets you. Like, you don't know if it's a real person or not. So we need 3 fuses. We don't have one. Like, Outlast was scary, but I wasn't really scared about the body horror, I guess. Or, like, the characters. Well, in a DLC, the Whistleblower DLC has some scary stuff going on. Hold on one moment. I will be right back a second. I didn't die. I'm here. I had to arranging some flowers real quick for Mother's Day. Thank you. I just want to create carnage. Yeah. I like the keys in this one. You can put it in your pocket. Because I think there was keys in the other game, but you couldn't put it in your pocket. I think you just carried it. Hello? Oh, sick, a shoe. Well, this is more like a foot. It's not really a shoe, because in this circumstance, I feel like they're feet. But... I mean, you have it in your pocket, but you take it out. Okay, you guys see this nice shoe? And there's this one. Oh, you can't pick that one up. There's this one. They're not feet. They're definitely shoes, not feet. Look at, see, that guy has a shoe on. They got shoes. Is this like where they make prosthetic limbs? Thank you. I really want to pick that up. Can I pick up the hand? No, he'd probably be like grossed out if he picked up the hand. Okay. I'm trying to make this not scary by picking up random stuff. Scared. But I am scared. Which way should we go? Should we go? I don't know, I'm gonna go this way. I think this is a dead end. Hey, I hate this. Hey. Really don't like this. Really don't. Oh, there's a collectible though. I wish I could use the arm as a weapon. But alas, I cannot. There's a lot of stuff happening. Thanks, let me in. Oh, sorry, I miffed that. I miffed it. I'll do it this time. I'll hold on. You actually have to hold on. It's not automatic. It kind of looks like there's enough light. But I'm still gonna bring my flashlight out. Nice to meet you, sir. I could see that you've got a little bit ahead of yourself, but don't lose your head. Okay. What is that? What is that? What is that? I don't like it. I hate this. Really gotta hand it to you. That was scary. Continuing the puns. I don't have anything to hit it with. Ew, I hate this. Why do I have to go in here? Huh? No! I don't know, I just stared at it. I kinda just let it get me. I thought it wouldn't. Okay. Yeah, dummy idiot. Oh, my flashlight automatically navigates to it. That's helpful. Okay, can you not jump? Thanks. Just don't jump. Just stop.
I'm gonna climb. Yep, you can also probably do that, and I hate that. Hopefully not. Oh, yes, you can. You most certainly can. Please, duck. Please stop. Please, I'm leaving. Maybe I got caught. Yeah, it's like, it is the hand from the Addams Family. I'm just making a run for it. All I can do is run from it. Okay. I don't think I can kill it. I thought maybe the light would kill it. Maybe that was like the importance of the flashlight. Yeah. Oh, here we go. You dodged me? How do you dodge me? Oh my gosh, you could dodge. You could dodge! Get back here! He dodges. They dodge! That's... How do they dodge? They don't have brains. Brains? You have brains? Triple check, the good old triple check. Quadruple check. Achievement called and stay dead. That's funny. Yeah, it gave me an achievement for hitting it a bunch. Dude, so many game achievements are puns, and I'm like, that's crazy. Oh, I need this. I could probably break that. I was kind of worried it was going to come back to life, though, when I got the fuse. I guess that what that is that the enemy of this area? Hands? It kind of looks like, I guess it's a fake hand, but... a little bit aggressive. I did all the work. Thank you. Where'd she go? Is she taking off all its fingers? Did you just, I guess... You just broke all its fingers. I get it. I understand. But isn't that kind of like weird? Yeah. Oh, ma'am. Can I help you? This is a Wendy's. This is a Wendy's number six. I think there's a single one over here. We need three of them, or do we just need one more? That's the real question. I guess this is technically not dark, right? Nuh-uh, you don't want me to go in there, do you? I don't want to go in there. Where else can we go? Oh, we need a fuse for these areas. I see. Okay. Okay, I guess we have to go through the weird red door hole. Which I don't really want to go through. I don't think we can go through this door. Yes. I like how they talk to each other. I think this is Soupy! Welcome! Welcome!
How are you? Hey, I hate this. I don't like this. Oh. Well, you'll just keep moving. You need a light on you. You need a light on you. Can you get away from the door, please? Welcome home. I need him to come. Wait, they move kind of fast. Do not flicker. No! I really don't like this. Yeah, we're just playing some Little Nightmares 2. Again. I don't want these guys to come to life. First, we had to deal with hands. Oh, first we had to deal with long neck school lady. Now we gotta deal with hands. The little hands like that. And now we gotta deal with whole people? Like, that are Doctor Who-y, Doctor Who angeling me? You guys better not. I see you, and you better not. Okay, I gotta go down there. That sucks. That sucks. Wait. Okay, can we... Why are there so many? Are they alive or not? I'm confused. Why do they gotta put so many and I don't even know which ones really move? That's so... They're so mean! Some of them gotta move. I can see that guy's underwear. So many. Okay, so it's definitely those two. We gotta just kinda. I'm not sure how to aim it yet. I've got to figure it out. Got to figure out the optimal... The optimal... area. We can go this way. Okay, we got past that part. Leave me alone! I see you're moving. I could see your physics. Look at us! He's dancing! Don't move like you didn't just move. I see you. I like how he goes back to that position every time. Who's gonna move here? One of you is, and I don't know who it is, and I don't want to find out. Yes. This is awful. I don't know what hellscape this is, but he's got a hanger for a head. I feel ill.
I feel not so good about this area. Where is my friend, huh? Why didn't she come with me? There's a little eye here. Eyes seem to be really prevalent, but like theme. Like watching. What could go wrong? What could go wrong? Let's be honest. What is that? Is that some... Mmm, yummy. Okay. They're fine. They can't hurt me. They can't hurt me. Thank you. Wait, they can't hurt me! This is really scary. Is this is like the scariest horror game I've probably ever played. One of them. Okay, let that happen. There's not enough of me to go around. Oh my god! I didn't expect to. Famous last is always the famous last words. They can crawl. These ones can crawl, and I hate that. Stop. Why are they crawling? And I gotta start from the beginning of that part. No, I'm gonna play this whole part. Like, just like this. That's how I feel. I'm horrified. I'm horrible. I'm gonna take a drink. I need a drink. Yeah, this game legitimately scary. I wish I could start after this part because the segments are pretty long. Okay, alright, yep, let's do that. It's okay, got it under control. Okay. Am I supposed to run through this? I think I'm supposed to run. And then that pops out? Don't worry. I needed my flashlight. I thought I could just run past them. They spawned in front of me too, I forgot. This is really hard. I also had my flashlight on the whole time. Flashlight. No, I was so close. was so close. My depth perception strikes again. My depth perception! No more scared face. No, I don't want to be happy either. I just want to be. So scary. Wait, it's hard to have an alt tab. Okay. Well, we almost did it. It gets easier every time, right? We just gotta, like, control them. I have to actively aim because I gotta itch my nose. Aim or else they're gonna get us because there's no auto aim on these guys. I gotta put the flashlight away. That's what it is. So you have to put the flashlight away or you can't grab. It's on Twitter already. I will look. Wait, that's kind of dangerous. I'll put it, you guys want me to put it up so you can see it here? We'll use this moment to take a break from the impending doom I'm feeling. It's really good though, it's really good. Top tier. Here, let me throw up this image. Thank you, Kai. I like it a lot. I actually really like it. I don't know what about it. Is it like the short hair that I like? I don't know. It's just so good. This is what? This is Mama Musei. It looks pretty good. It looks super good, Kai. Thank you. I really like it. Make it, let's enhance. We got the sultry expression. The wink. The wink. We got the colors. It's like my outfit converted into a mature outfit. I really like it. Mommy. Definitely mommy material. This is what I'm gonna look like in I don't know how many years. Whenever I become mother. Can you guys see it? That's like truly like the. I didn't even know how to do a mom voice. I was gonna try to do one. But it's very good. I love it. I retweeted it so fast. I love it. Thank you so much. The mom energy is real, it's very incredible. That was a very nice thing to see after suffering for so long. Suffering for so long in this game. I always love Kai's art. I commissioned him before for art. Oh! He's very talented. to keep them really far away because I have to put the flashlight away before them way sooner. Maybe that's what it is. Hungry, hungry. My heart is beating so fast. My heart is beating so fast right now. The adrenaline from this. I'm actually scared. Not this part anymore. It doesn't scare me. I'm gonna be so relieved when we actually get past this part. No. Dies right away. I think they had a demo with this part of the game in it. If only I could kill them. Oh, I didn't mean to slide. Hey, maybe I could use the slide to my advantage. Nope. Aw, stupid. Dumb, dumb, dumb! 200 IQ play, actually. Don't worry, now I get a reset. Dumb mannequin. That's why I was calling it dumb. Because why does he get to grab me? I feel like I may be... The flashlight's an advantage, obviously, but... It's better definitely to walk, I think. That's gonna be my strategy. It's definitely better to walk because running, they move faster because you leave their sight faster, and also it's hard to control the light when you're running because the light's controlled by where you're moving, not where you're looking. I mean, it is where you're looking, I guess. But it's like kind of both, right? We're gonna get through this part, everyone. I have optimism. I have optimism on my side. In the meantime, what are you guys gonna eat for dinner today? If you haven't already eaten dinner. Where's my giant stick thing? Couldn't I definitely, like, knock them out? I got this. This part is easy now, so... I just get too close. Wait for this guy to come out. Pasta sounds yummy. That was really close, though. Just the fringe of the flashlight. I guess they're not stunned anymore by the very fringe. It has to be, like, the direct beam. I should back up from them so I have, like, more time. I'm gonna walk. Take it leisurely. Oh, okay, not that leisurely. Maybe a little bit faster than that. Another thing I like about this game, there's not really like a difficulty setting, so I feel like it's a game that a lot of people could do because I feel like even though I'm not really great at most games, this game isn't too bad. This game isn't too bad. And if you're, it's very, I don't really play platformer games, but it's very friendly. Oh, how'd he grab me? I should have stood up. Well, thank you. I just enjoy playing games. I think they're fun to play. I'm just gonna crouch this whole time. That's actually not okay. That's not the strat I wanna do. I can kind of hear what direction they're gonna come out with before they come out. Okay. This part is the hard part. We're gonna grab this guy. Okay, we got all three, we got all three. We have a fourth one. I feel like I'm doing call-outs in a game. We got a fourth one. We gotta put the flashlight away and climb. Yes! Yes! Auto-saved. Yes! That's a lot of managing! Finally a light. I'm gonna take a drink of my drink. Woo! Yeah! Do you ever play a part so intense in a game, like you're shaking because you're trying to get through it? That's like... I need to take a deep breath. I got a little too excited. Wait. Look here, guys. This is novelty. The soap slides. Because it's wet and it's slippery and it's soap. And it's on tile. That's a good touch. Physics. Now we have soap. I don't trust this guy. Do I need a soap somehow? I think I need to like climb on him. Oh yeah. Maybe if I soap it up. Want to climb on him. That's not something I really envisioned myself doing. So I can push it, but... How? But how? It happened to you in rhythm game? I think rhythm games are pretty intense, too. What is this? Oh, it's a drain. Oh. I don't know if I really want to go back in here. Is this just a bonus area? Oh my gosh, kind of gruesome. Can I get in here? No. Ew. I wonder if the collectibles have something to do with who you are. I think I've gotten all the collectibles so far. A little sponge, look at this! Hey, what is this? Oh, I see. I see what we're gonna do. I see, I get it. Come here. But I didn't mean it. I didn't mean it. I didn't mean it. I didn't mean it, okay? I wasn't ready. Thought I was ready. No, no, no! I turned off my flashlight too soon. At least it starts me here. They're pretty generous about that. Can't see, so I gotta turn the light on first. Maybe I could like wing it though. I did jump into his arms. Yep. Just where am I gonna aim this flashlight? Okay, we just gotta lead him in here and then do the switch. So just you think I can make a run for it? Okay. Got you. I guess. Even though, like, I'm still scared. What about this guy in the bathtub? He's all chained in there. Barely caught on there. Wow, another dark area? Who would have guessed? That one wasn't as bad, because it's kind of manageable when there's like one or two. But when there's like a multiple of them, that's when it gets like scary. It's kind of scary. Alright, could we not do that? I don't even see you yet. I haven't even seen you. Can we have a discussion about this being not good for my health and... I can't outrun them! I like how I was literally talking about, oh yeah, it's not bad when there's just one, but when there's like 10 of them... and the game's like, yeah, I bet. Me, please stop. Okay. What? Yeah, okay. Maybe if we go this way, maybe if... I don't want these guys to wake up. We want to wake up as many not wake up as many guys as possible. We need a shining light. I said no. There's some guy stuck.
tricky. Okay. Don't move, please. Okay, you're allowed to move a second. Just don't. Okay, that's it. That's it. Calm down. Keep my hand on the button as much as possible. That was ridiculous. That was ridiculous. That was only slightly worse than the other one. I'm getting better at it though. I figured it out. I'm very proud of myself. I don't know, what did I get from this area? Thank you. I thought I was gonna need something to hit that, and then I was like, oh no, I just threw the thing. No! What if it just broke? Wouldn't that be... It wouldn't be funny, it'd be kind of tragic. There we go. Now me next. Me next. Okay, thank you. Now let's just take this, because I don't want any hellish nightmares coming out of there, so just let's... Yep. I don't think there's anything else that needs fuses. Okay. We did it! We got past the area with the flashlight guys! What is the Doctor Who thing called? Weeping Angels or something like that? Ugh! It gives me, like, the creepy crawlies. It's just like, just my luck. Thank you for grabbing another fuse. That'd be great. Thank you. She's so helpful now. Yeah, they don't walk, they teleport. It's like if you're not looking at them, right? Can you not? That's a funny glitch. She put it in the same socket thing. Then she took it out again. She's like, oh, sorry. Oh, my bad. Hold on one moment. Okay. It's a very dark room once again. What a surprise. This game really does get you on edge. It's well done, the level design. The timing of things I really like. I hope now Six gets to experience this. I see a lot of bodies. Like prefer the hands over the whole bodies because you know how fast legs are compared to fingers? Pretty fast.
You ever try to walk with your fingers, guys? Of course not. Maybe, though. Maybe. Why did some of them move? And obviously they're putting, like, brains inside teddy bears and stuff. Oh. I got it. I don't got it. Thank you for covering that for me. I gotta get him when he comes out. He dodges every time. Can't jump. 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 He has like a recovery period. It's okay, you can let it out. I wonder. What is, are you okay, Chirpy? Are you okay? I like how I was just saying that the hands would be better, and then suddenly the game's like, well, hands, here you go. The timing is like immaculate for everything. We're gonna do better this time. Kind of like a little speed run. Oh my gosh, you're so annoying. Yeah. Their little dodge is pretty powerful. Maybe I should wait until it dodges and then do it. Trying to figure out the timing. It's like when I was fighting the dolls, it's like the timing is different for every monster, so. Which I like, because I like how it's not too consistent. Where are you gonna come from? You gotta do it after it jumps, okay. I figured it out, guys. Big brain. Jump. Oh. I gotta let not get too close though. But yeah, I really am liking. I hate it, but I like it. Like, it's definitely for someone who likes horror stuff, good game. If you don't like horror stuff, this game, it still scares me even though I play a lot of horror. I'll hit it. Okay, good. Yeah, come here. Okay, twice? I think it's three times? Away from it. So I think six will open the door. It's easy to become desensitized to horror games, in my opinion, and horror stuff, because there's a lot of it, right? And a lot of, like, the same tropes I find in horror games. I'm getting a little bit better every time. Jump. Three times I have to hit him. On this one. do it. Oh, that was pretty forgiving. That was pretty forgiving. I think it glitched out. Okay, I gotta kill the other one before the other one spawns, ideally. Or kill it right away after. Because two of them, they jump at different times. Which is kind of difficult. Why don't you choke one of these out? You, like, killed someone before. It was a little bit too forgiving. Did I not hit it? Wow, I gotta do it right away. Wow, that I missed. Hit it once. This one's about to come out. Wow, they if you're really close to it. I see. So the only reason I'm dying is because right now is because they're getting close to me, like really close, and I'm not able to move with the thingy very fast. So if I could just keep my distance long enough. Yes, I have faith. I am very, very optimistic about this since I am getting better very slowly at timing it. Every try, I don't really get frustrated very easily at like retrying things in games like this because I need to get over here. Because you get better every time, so get better every time. Stop dodging! Once, okay. Scuttle off. Now you just gotta kind of think about it that way. That you. I don't have to move as far away as I think. Okay, I got it. Because they've already decided their path when they lunge like that, they've already decided they can't move sideways. Kind of a misstep. I can help you now. I got it, yes. Also, welcome back, Trippy. I'm glad your Wi-Fi is back. Look at all these weird masks. Kinda interesting though. We'll just break stuff. It wasn't letting me dropping it for- I'm just walking on them and dropping them. Carnage. Yeah, they kind of look like kind of realistic, yeah. Except for the guy. These kind of look like, you guys ever read the book Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark? It kind of looks like that. Can you not do what you're doing? Oh, wow, I hate this. Wow. Yeah, it looks like we found the master of this domain, that's for sure. Look, he's hanging to the ceiling like a little guy. Are you crying? He's putting a guy together. Mm-hmm.
Oh, he looks under there. Why? Why are all these places? Why? Stop. You didn't really look very good. How is he on the ceiling? That's what I'm confused about. This game, they ain't monsters. They're, kind of unique, you know. Okay, I gotta time it. He's gonna camp these two beds. Under there. I'm Soul. Is it safe to go? I don't know if it's safe. No, it's not safe. Wait till he goes back over there. We're gonna have to grab a block? He's gonna see. Oh, no, he's not. No, he's not. No, he's not. Move. She almost pushed me out. What is he doing? It's like a sick game of Dollhouse. Grab anything. Just anything will work. Or maybe we should grab the block. What do you guys think? The block, maybe? What would be heavier? I guess the block. I don't think the monkey head was heavy enough. This is your worst nightmare, a man hanging from the ceiling. He stays for like 5 seconds. And then he moves on again. Run. Oh, that's dumb. I'm gonna have to hide. Oh, he definitely can see me. Run really fast. I missed. Please do not look under here. Please don't. I think if you do it fast enough, he doesn't see you. He didn't see six! I like how she just waltz up. I guess they can't really see the NPC. Or the... That would be probably too hard if they could, because you can't really control her. These are some, freaky shelves. If someone told you not to look under a specific area 9 out of 10 times, I'll probably look. I don't like that. Get your little hands out of here. Oof, hate it. Hate it. Do we go down here? Do we just drop down? Oh, she fell. So this is like a hospital, but not really. It's more like a morgue. We need a key. We need a key. Thanks, that's really gross. Thank you, though. That's so gross. Imagine getting in, like... These are, like, dead people. We gotta make some sort of... None of these better come alive. None of these better come alive. Oof. Okay. Here? They're like dead people! I hate this. A RE7 moment, yeah, where it pops out of the thing. These bodies aren't very long either. I don't know if they're just the legs, but... This is supremely gross. Supremely gross. I hate it. He didn't clean his sink out. I like how you move wrong and they hear you, but you're doing all these pulling out of things and they don't hear you. I need to leave. I'm so scared. I'm so scared. Also, how do they know that this opens on the other side? That's what I'm wondering. Because it didn't really seem obvious to me. Please. Help me with the door. climb these. Whoops. Okay, so yeah, that's how you climb it, but I couldn't climb it like that. It must be inconvenient to be... Oh, huh. I wasn't on the platform all the way. I almost didn't make that one either. Those little, the little things you climb in, they're pretty tricky. God, I remember that exact moment in Resident Evil 7, too. That's why that's so funny, because it's, I think it scared me almost every time. Muscle Dream, thank you so much for the resubscribe. Deepengu MB, now that I know how to pronounce it. Nine-month streak. Can you not look at me or see me or perceive me? Thank you. What is this dude doing? That's what I'm wondering, like... He's taking these bodies. So these are obviously the people that are he's, like, been working on. Because there's dead people that have real feet. Cut off his body parts. You're gonna stay in here? You're crazy. She's crazy. Oh my god, am I gonna have to like end his life support? I don't wanna do that. I don't want anything to do with this person, or I don't know if it's a creature. The sound effects are very realistic. Is he doing, like, CPR on him? Okay, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to kill your buddy, though. It's a like a time trial. Like a... She's so fast. She does it so fast. I feel like I can't go that fast. I wish it started you off like in there. I guess I do hold it. I have this kind of weird, when I go from places, it's like, maybe I'm not holding it down long enough, but I feel like I'm crouching up when I go down that part. Maybe I am. No. This might take me a bit. Compared to her. Hold on, I want to look at the... sprint? So... oh, I was doing it. Okay, I got past that part. I have some weird, it's like some stagger. But I can deal with it. Burn him! Really burning him! Oh my god, she's warming her hands! Oh my god! That's valid though, he did just try to kill us multiple times. I'm sorry to cut your celebration short. Whoops, sorry about that. I always do that, I always don't hit the button. I mean, they're terrible people doing terrible things, to be honest. Like, the teacher, I don't know if she was really, like, bad, because, I don't know, definitely the dolls are weird. But this guy, he's, like, putting people together. Oh.
hospitalized. I got the achievement. Is this the last part of the game? Which way should we go? That was pretty wild. I think at our next autosave, I'm gonna end for today. I'm not sure how much is left. We keep going into buildings that are arguably the worst buildings. Okay. Oh, look, a shoe, finally. A good note to end on, a good note to end on. We beat everything. That was really scary. The second part was really scary, way scarier than the first. And we have our little shoe. So, I think this is a good place to end for today. I don't know how much is left. I heard the game is... We are ending a little bit early. We're ending about 30 minutes earlier. For the sake of Mother's Day. Oh, what if there's only like a little bit left? I'm very curious. Okay, I'm just gonna go a little bit ahead. I'm gonna go a little bit ahead. I'm curious. It was pretty eventful. I'm just gonna go a little bit ahead, guys. A little bit. I wanna know. I wanna keep playing it, to be honest. It's very, very, very... that guy's throwing some stuff into the street. Where is it coming from? There's so many questions I have where it's like, why are there people... dead. Why are there just clothes? Alright, okay, now that we're in the next building, I will give you guys the shoe. Oh, I was gonna hold her hand. Alright. And we got a lot done. It was a lot. We're gonna see who else is streaming. Let me go back to hello. Ah, thank you so much. I don't know who donated $10, but thank you so much. They said congrats. Thank you so much. Thank you. We're at 120 now. Our final goal. That's incredible. So I'm very happy. We did it, guys. First charity stream. Success. It was a lot of fun. We will continue playing Little Nightmares, though. Of course. We'll be streaming Tuesday. I'm going to take a day break in between. Or I think Tuesday. Because I think my Tuesday is free this week. It might not be. One day this week I'm not free. So. Yes! I'm very, 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 very hype. Okay. But yeah, it was a lot of fun playing. I hope you guys all have a fantastic evening. Thank you again for coming. And thank you, Kai, for the $1 donation. And thank you so much for the Mama Musei art. It's gonna be in my head forever. Thank you, Deepengu, for the tier 1 resubscribe. Let's see if we can find a raid. Mm-hmm.
I'm looking for a fellow team member to raid. There's a lot of people that participated in this stream event. But I hope you guys have a good dinner. I'm about to eat dinner myself. If I can navigate the internet correctly. Let's see, I'm trying to figure out who's live and who isn't live. How about I go to Attack of the Lady? She's drawing scary characters. Her art is really, really good. I will hydrate. Thank you. She is also fundraising this weekend, so gonna spread the love and send you guys over to her. I could start the raid. I always, like, have a hard time. Read. Definitely cool. I love when people are doing art. I love art streams. It looks like tradition. It's like traditional art too, which is really, really cool. All right. So I'll send you guys over now. Thank you again so much for coming, and I will put the next stream on Twitter. Does my Twitter command work? So if you want to know when I stream next, Twitter would be the best bet. Thank you guys so much. It was a lot of fun. I'm really looking forward to continuing. So, okay. I'm going to send you guys off now. Take care, everyone. Ohatsukareoshan. Until next time. Take care, and I'll always be cheering you on, okay? Bye-bye. Thank you.